Doe mijn daily livestream here on YouTube. On this stream, or on this channel, you will see my daily trades live as how they unfold during the day or during the moment. And I will also explain why it is pretty important to use stop losses if you do day trading, and why it also can be handy or smart to do when you do long trades, long-term trades. Let's go. This is my first video, and I might be a little bit rusty, but that shouldn't be an issue. The longer I will do this, the better I will be, and the nicer it will be for you guys and girls. So, let's go. This is my live account, and on the 5th of April, 5 days ago, I placed a long trade on the US 30, as you can see, and it was on top of the mountain, which was obviously not really a nice trade to do for the short term. For the long term, it might be, but how long will it be for it to go back? Nobody knows. And was this avoidable? Yes, it was. And could I exit the trade earlier? Yes, I could, but I didn't know. I didn't do. I'm sorry. And I didn't do it also to make this video, but also just to learn the market and how to see the swings of the market. How will they unfold over a period of time? How will the drawback be and the retracement? And is it predictable with some lines and maybe a Fibonacci retracement? I am not really using indicators since indicators are lagging, and lagging indicators are not really something that you wanna use in a trade. And as you can see, 5 days after I placed the trade, it is still $25 in the min. And not only that, as you can see here in my account history, I also lost due to interest that needed to be paid. Interest over the weekend is $1. And interest for one night is 36 cents. Now the trade is being placed at the 5th. I don't see it standing up here. This is a close trade. You can see it up here. I placed it on 15:38. So where was it exactly? Well, it was, I think, in this candle. Yeah, it was somewhere in that candle. So if you go back, it was around 15. 15. 15:38. So if you go back on 5 minutes, oh, 5 minutes, I said 15:38. I placed a long trade. The reason why we placed this trade had to do with the fact that this shooted up, it retraced, and it might bounce back. Based on what? I will remove those indicators up here since they are not really an added value at the moment. So you go. Why did I place the long trade on this channel, on this candle up here? I placed it in this candle. I will mark it. This candle. And that I will show you what my reason was to place the trade up here and miserably failed, also because I didn't use a stop loss. But I can always exit right now, but like I said, I want to see how the market goes. You can always place a second trade, which I highly recommend not to do. Never add to a losing trade is what they say, and that is something that I can confirm. I can confirm that because I lost here $70 in the past, because I added to a losing trade, which went miserably wrong. It were two long trades, and the market plumped like I don't know, causing me a $70 loss. I just closed the trades because I didn't saw the market going back up. Well, I should have left them because the market, it went up. And it went even so high that it could have made me plus 70 buck instead of minus 70 buck. Anyway, traders make money, traders lose money. In the end, you can see that I'm still in the plus 30 buck. Yeah, so even after losing 70 euro, and I had an initial deposit of 300 euro, as you can see, PayPal, 300 buck, I'm still in the plus. So I still consider myself as a profitable trader. Though, don't ask me about the time machine, because we're talking about the period of, that's not true, I started in 2017 up here, but I skipped 1 year of trading with this broker, because I was with other brokers, as you can see. I stopped here in 17, and I started again in 19 with this broker, so yeah, at least the whole year of 18 was gone. And you can see here also that I had some nice trades. I had a loss of 126, 86, 44, but also pluses of 125, 170, and even higher. Well, not, no, that was the highest. So yeah, you know, trade goes and trade, they come and go, and you learn with the mistakes that you make. So back to what I wanted to show you. Why did I place the trade initially in the long? Why did I place the long and not the short? Well, it had mostly to do with this. On the day can I can remove this one. We all know where the trade is, so I will remove it to make it clear. On the day chart, what are you doing? Usually you place some nice horizontal lines on places where it consolidates. Here it consolidated. What is this now again? Let me change that into a nicer color. The color is okay, but let me make it thin. So, at least we can see it. Yeah, this was an area of resistance and support, also based on the past. Here we had a nice resistance, a nice resistance, and a nice resistance. Yeah, it was a nice resistance support line. Here we had a huge violation of it and a bigger violation going down. Anyway, it recovered. This was 18 as far as I know. Yeah. September 18. It recovered from that. Broke it. Not so hard, but it broke. So we scaled down to the 4 hour. And we already know this is the daily resistance and support. You have a nice thingy going on up here. So yeah. It might always keep support on it, which it didn't do. You can see on this 4 hour candle. On the 1 hour, and I usually don't go below 1 hour, I placed other nice lines, which was also this one, and this was the consolidation zone, if you ask me, and I placed it up here. Always take the candles after it started to consolidate. Now this is a nice consolidation area around a daily support and resistance line. It broke and I had something like big push, bigger push. So we zoom in this area. Yeah. We zoom in that area. Oh. Yeah. And we can go to half an hour candle, which makes the consolidation a little bit better. With a nice push. A small retracement, it went nice up, a big push again, and a nice flat consolidation area, which made me draw lines like this. And I had a nice one up here, which was being tested here and tested again, and big resistance up here. Oh, and we all know I placed my trade up here way too early, way too early. And I didn't pay really attention of it later on, and it dropped down, dropped down, dropped down, and it continuously to drop down until now. Here it starts to consolidate in a big wave. It's already here now for 2 days. This was yesterday. Yeah. And as you can see, it is still bouncing on one of my lines that I dropped and that was drawn based on a previous analysis. The line up here was based on this candle here, and I didn't know this area yet because we were here. Yeah. So this is also something, it's being test it, test it, test it, test it again, reject it again, and yeah, what goes down must go back up, as we think, but you never know. So I'll remove this. Now I'll just keep it, and let's just see how this will look like if we do some Fibonacci lines in it. But we do a Fibonacci, and I will base that on the daily chart. Small swing. I will take lowest point up here after a nice retracement for this part up here, and this is a nice area, I think. So we take the retracement of Fibonacci. Pardon me. And as you can see, it tested here on the 11.8. It violated 11.8. And it violated also the 23.6. And it is now bouncing again around a resistance line based on the candle here. Which makes me doubt if this even would go back up, because it might also go down to the 31.8. And yeah, if they want to blow up my account, they should go to 61.8 and then I'm out. Then my account would probably be blown. Because this is something that with a 300 buck account and a free margin of 180 buck is not something that you can carry out, I think. But let's just see. Not that I like to blow up my account, don't get me wrong. But these are things that you're learning from. I traded a long time. As you can see, I have different kinds of options that I traded. I traded also cryptocurrency in the past with this account, which brought me a lot of money, but also costed me a lot of money. And the cryptocurrency is seen up here, Ether USD, Ethereum. I also traded here in the Mexican pesos, I think. Anyway, it is Forex. And it brought some positive trades, all small trades, but it doesn't matter. Small trades, a lot of small trades add up eventually. And the biggest challenge that you have is a good money management system. So yeah, you know, I'm just practicing with this account, live account. Why practicing with a live account? It's also due to psychological reasons. At least if you lose, you know what how your body will react and how you can control your temper and stuff like that. And since a demo account is not real money, you wouldn't also have the feeling of losing real money. And yeah, 300 bucks is, it is a lot, I know. But it is also not something that that will make you make you go broke if you blow it up. I mean, I know guys who lost 40,000 bucks, even more. Real money that they couldn't afford to lose, but they simply lost it. Reason, I don't know. Might be greediness, might be just mistakes like how I made them, think that the market would go up, but eventually it didn't, and they didn't at a stop loss, and all account was eaten. I don't know, but what I do know is that it should be smart to use a stop loss. In this case, I could have placed a stop loss up here, or maybe based on the 11.8, which in that case was only a loss of about 5 euro, as you can see here. 5 buck. No, I don't like. And a 5 buck stop loss is better than a 25 loss. And then also you have to pay your interest every night that is being added up. And they gave you a dividend, but they also took it the same day. I don't know why, but not funny. And you keep paying that here, short interest. Oh, that's from another trade. Anyway, as you can see, you pay your interest for having trades open, even if they're in the min. Your broker doesn't care, believe me. They just take your money. And you can go to them and send an email. Give me back my money. But they will not give you back your money. You're playing the game, and you have to pay playing the game. So, it's up to you. You're going to use a stop loss, you're not going to use a stop loss. I would recommend you to use a stop loss. On the other hand, stop losses, as you can see, I used a lot of stop losses. Here, stop loss orders, and a lot of them are being hit just by a small retracement. And I can take this for an example. I will remove everything that I draw up here, and I will show you why it can also be nasty to use a freaking stop loss. Because stop losses, though they are meant to protect your account, they can also work against your account. Take this one for example. We bought it at a price of $26,105. I will place a line. $26,105.8. I will make it very thin. And I placed that one on 9-4. And it was yesterday. It was yesterday. So on 26, and how late was it? 14:36. It was around this candle. In this candle. I will remove the line so you can see it better. On this nice candle, we placed an up. And I know also where this up was for. This was how do you say that? You know, I had the losing trade. I add up another buy for in a losing trade, so they will meet in the middle, and you can just, that's how I call it, chicken out and break even, because one gains and the other one is getting lesser, so you will break even somewhere in the middle. On this point, my current trade, who is now minus 25, was around minus 6, so I could have chickened out. But the issue was, I think, well, this might retrace a little higher to, for example, this point. But what happened? This nasty candle up here, since I blocked it in with, I think, a trailing stop. I think I had a 900 point or a 1000 point trailing stop. Must be a 1000 point trailing stop. This candle just hit my stop loss and pulled me out. And since that was 8:30 in the evening, I was probably watching a movie or whatsoever. Didn't notice it. Out of the market, and yeah, the only thing that they gave you was 39 freaking cents. It's a waste. On the other hand, that trade was being protected for getting an even bigger loss. On the other hand, like you see, using a stop loss in what form, what form doesn't matter, being a trailing stop or you do it manually, can also work against you. And I have a lot of them. I have a lot of them. Here is the same. Was placed also on the same day, on the 5th. In the morning, making me convinced that the market would go up. Well, in fact, the market crashed the same day. It literally crashed the same day. Yeah. This was 5:04, 8 o'clock in the morning. We placed it on this candle with a trailing stop also, nice, after a few nice pushes up. And it pushed you out. And the market went up. Actually also hitting, no, not hitting my take profit. My take profit was higher than I expected, than the market went. I expected the market to go higher than it went. But that was an issue to begin with. Anyway, it pushed me out already, warning me, do not go in. Do not go in because I'm not firm enough or strong enough or whatsoever. Yeah. But this candle, a big one. Even it had a big week, I thought this market would push up. Then the news came from Boeing. Oh, that was here, the news of Boeing. And no, not Boeing. It was Boeing, right? I think it was Boeing. Anyway, the news came the day the production was halved. And the market crashed like, I don't know. And it is still trying to recover from that news article that here was. And I saw it too late. When I saw the news about Boeing, if I knew it here already, because it was announced 16 hours before this crash came. This crash came 16 hours after the news came. So you had plenty enough time to go out of the market. I would have taken my loss up here. I would have taken my loss, six, seven bucks, but I didn't saw it. I didn't know. And that's an issue, ladies and gentlemen. That's really an issue. And now I'm still in the trade. Yeah, that doesn't really bring me money. It only costs me money. And I wonder if I should go out. On the other hand, markets always recover. And I think I told you in the beginning that we would analyze also and see what the market will do in the next few days, what I would think that it will do. So let's also do a little analyze. I analyzed it in the past. And I took this candle up here, those two big candles, as you can see. Always take the first two candles after, in this example. If you want to draw trend lines, that's how I do it. I'm not saying that you're supposed to do it. I'm just saying my opinion and my way of trading, my way of thinking. And what I always do is if there is a shift in the market, and of course we don't know this yet because you're basically around here. What I always do is putting already a trend line. Basically when this candle is closing and it closes below the other candle, and preferably in this how it is drawn up here, I'll draw a rectangle so that we don't see the rest. Can we make this also in color to hide it or not? Yeah, we can do. Oh yeah, Heineken. Dark blue maybe? No, I cannot hide it. That's nasty. Now I can't do anything with it anymore. Yeah, here it is again. Oh, it is not really doing what I wanted to do. But let's just assume we don't see what is in the blue stuff, making it easier to do. What I prefer and always do. You're not really listening, huh? Oh, like this. If a candle closes below the closed of the previous candle, I will start drawing trend lines. So I'll draw a trend line like this, connecting to the wicks. I always connect to the wicks. They give you the best and the best information as far as I think. And I highly appreciate it if you just comment below the video. You can also send a chat, I think. What I always ask you to do is just place a comment. Am I doing something wrong? Am I doing something right? Do you think different than me or whatsoever? I really appreciate it if you let me know. Also, if you want to see more of my daily live show, hit the thumbs, hit the subscribe button, and follow me so you would be notified. I think in YouTube there is also a little bell, one that will give you a notification when I'm going live again. And usually I'm live at the same time, daily. I will probably also do this on a Sunday evening, slightly before the market will open. I'm not trading at the time. It's simply too late for me. But hit the subscribe button, follow me, like it, or dislike it if you like. That's also possible. Give me feedback so I can improve and make it better for you guys to listen to. And let's see if we can help each other and learn from this. I have a message here in the back office. I don't know what it is. I can also welcome everybody. Live chat is open, as you can see. Okay, I'm getting all kind of messages. I don't know. Anyway, I will draw the trend line. First, I will start with the 1 hour. I prefer to trade on the 4 hour. As you can see, I have here a trade line or a trend line on the 1 hour. Now, by this time, you can delete it and place it on the 4 hour. There is a nice 4 hour week up here and a nice 4 hour week up here. Drawing a trend line for me. Current price line, that's not really interesting to know. And this is a nice. Nice and a nice violation of the trend line, but it tested it again and it seems to go away from it now. Well, we also have a support, preview support if you ask me. It's somewhere around here. It's also a daily support or assistance. It's just how you want to see it, support, resistance, whatsoever. Seems to bounce on it again. Seems to reject this area, and I hope it, since I have still a long way to go to recover. If that will recover anyway. But what I think this market will do, based on my current analysis, that it will recover. It will recover. That is one thing for sure. It is the Dow that we are talking about anyway. So yeah, unless the world economy will break, then this will plump down even more, and that will just be a market crash. And I really don't see that doing. If you look at the week chart, we came from a really long multiple year going up since 2008. It was a nice, yeah, almost consistent push up. And this looks a little bit like the Bitcoin explosion that we had. And after that, it went just messy. And I'm not talking about the football player messy, but the chart is just messy. The daily chart is even worse. I had, by the way, some nice gains here from December up till there. But you lose that instantly if you don't look out. Anyway, I will usually go back to the 1 hour and a half an hour 30 minute chart. 30 minutes chart can give you a nice image, so there is a lot of noise in it, but it can give you a nice image if you draw triangles, ascending and descending triangles, on what the market might do. For example, we can draw a line from this point to that point, and you can see that it just nicely follow the trend down. We have a body resistance up here, as far as if you ask me. Let's just take the line that we already draw. Oh, I don't know what you're doing, but you go back. Appa. Like this, then we have this one. I'll also make it blue. Nice color that we can see. This one, for example. On the 50 minutes, the 5 minute and the 1 minute, don't go there. Don't go to the 1 minute, guys. I traded also in the 1 minute before. It gives you too much noise, too much false breakouts, etc., etc. 50 minutes is the same. 5 minutes, I mean. Don't go to a 5 minute chart unless you just want to scalp some few pips. Then it might be nice, but for the medium term long trade, long term trades, it's not really ideal. And what I learned also in the past is that the lower time frames gives you a lot of false signals. And if you're not experienced enough and you don't know what you're doing, you will make a lot of mistakes. I learned from that in the last 3 years. I made a lot of mistakes. I never blowed up an account. Honestly speaking, I never blowed up an account. I have a nice account up here and it is still living. So I went up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. I started with 300. I ended up somewhere around 400 or 500. I think that was due to this. Yeah. It was a nice income. And I had a lot of other small incomes that added up. But I told you also, this broke it down again instantly. And I recovered from it. Yeah. I also did an extra fund from another MT4 account, $25. So I could just play a little bit better. Oh, I had a nice $50 gain again. Last seven, last eight. You know, it's just playing on the 50 minutes. Honestly, it is not really something that is worth doing. You can make better decisions on high term time frames. So I still use 30 minutes to seek entry points or to see what candles are doing. Yeah. What I think this market will do, honestly speaking, you can see the difference already here on the 4 hour chart. 4 hour chart. 1 hour chart, you can see a nice week. 30 minute, you know, You can see a lot. But anyway, we have a nice triangle here. And it is on the lower point. So what I think this will do, and I'm not going to say that you should go for an entry. I'm not going to say entry points or whatsoever. But if this stay on the low side of the triangle, there is a big possibility that it would go down even more. It should behave itself around this area and break above the line for a nice trend to go up. So what I think, honestly speaking, that this market would do is go down even more. And we can see that tomorrow. We can see that tomorrow. I will do a live stream tomorrow again. Around the same time. Same place. Same time. Same account. And yeah, let's see. Let's see what it does. What it will do. Nobody knows to begin with. Nobody will know to begin with. And probability. It's all about probability. 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 So let me know what you think about it, guys. I really like to hear what you guys think. You think I make a wrong analysis, I made some mistakes, or I have to change other stuff, let me know. I want to learn from it also, and I want to make a nice channel where we can just simply exchange ideas, become better at trading, and start earning with trading. And maybe, well, not maybe, I'm sure I will bring this account to a number with at least 6 figures. Yeah, let's go for that. Yeah, it might take a little while, but hey, you can scale up. I can deposit a little bit more money too, so I can buy bigger contracts. I'm not just simply trading with a 0.01 contract. It's nothing. But it is still, as you could see, in the course of half an hour, you probably saw the amount of money going up, down in a pretty nice way. Yeah. It's just how much money do you want to invest and how much money do you want to have in return. This is just trading with a small account. Small money. Yeah, but at least you will train your psychological feeling. When you lose a buck, it probably will make you feel greedy. I shouldn't have done that. I knew it. Or whatsoever. You will have funky reactions. You will lie to yourself. Believe me, I did it also. You can see it with this trade. I keep telling myself that would go back up more. No worries, no worries, it will go back up. 5 days later, it is not up, and it gives me a huge loss. So stop lying to yourself. At least I'm not saying it to you, but to myself. And close the trade if you're in the min. You could really reassess this trade, and knew you could see it would go down. I'm not going to draw lines or use indicators to show you that it really would go down, because you already know the freaking result. Everybody you see on the internet, all the traders you see on the internet, they always talk from an already existing chart. And look, if you do it like this, then it would go down. It gives you a signal of going down. Yeah, I already saw that the chart went down, mate. Give me some information on a live chart while it is unfolding itself. And assess it while it is being busy. Don't talk from the past. I can also tell you that this market would go down. Tell me more. I will draw the line up here. This market would go down more, believe me. Yeah. It gave a signal already or whatsoever, I don't know. Hey, I'm not going to do that. We're going to trade on this channel live. And we're going to see what happens live. And if we made a mistake, we probably learned from it. And it is well documented, because videos on YouTube won't disappear. Yeah. So I'm telling you now, based on what I see up here, we just have to wait. And I think that would be... this is 4 candles. I think we have to wait another 8 hours, 7 hours, before a reaction will occur up here. And it might go do this. Can I draw a free line up here or not? No, I cannot draw free lines up here. Let me speak if I can draw some lines. No, trend line, no. Vertical lines, no. No. Line chart, what? No. No. I cannot draw free lines. That's a waste. Anyway, maybe we can follow my cursor. It might do a little bit like this, break it, go a little bit down, and then eventually go up or whatsoever. A little bit in the same trend as you can see up here. It can also stay up here low and just go down like, I don't know. On the 4-hour chart, you can see it already. The push down, big push. Engulfing candle, 3-4 hour candles are being engulfed completely with the body. Even four, to be honest, four candles are being taken over. You can even take this candle if you like. So we talk about 5 candles being taken over completely from week to week, and the body is only until body also all candles are being engulfed, body to body. It's a strong signal of something that would go down. Yeah, you could see it on this candle also. Big, big, big push. And it didn't recover yet from it. Here we already see a week coming on again, and I'm talking about the 4-hour candle. High probability that this would go down even more. High probability. But, okay, I'm still in the trade for, I'm still in with a long trade. So I better take my baseball bat and smash it back up. But yeah, sadly enough, I don't have that influence on the market. So let's just hope what we'll do. Volume is not good. The volume here goes down. It doesn't really tell me that this would go back up again. It only confirms me a little bit that it would go down more. And I think this would go down more. I don't hope so. But let's just see tomorrow. Like I said, in a small 8 hours, maybe 16 hours, and we would know it more. Might consolidate a little longer like it did here. This is also a consolidation of 30 hours. So yeah. You don't know. You don't know. But based on based on my current analysis up here, this doesn't really seems to be a good development here in the market. I really want to hear from you guys. How do you think about it? What do you think about it? What do you think the market will do? Just smash it in the comments. The comments are open for everybody. And if you have points for me to improve, like the sound quality or topics to talk about or whatsoever, just let me know. I will improve. I will make it nicer and better for you. Do me a favor. Smash the like or dislike button. If you dislike it or like it, place a comment also why you do it. Hit the subscribe button, help me to grow my channel, and I will help you to grow your account for trading. And we will have a win-win situation, a mutual win-win situation. And I want to provide this information to you on YouTube, and I'm not going to sell you anything or whatsoever. I don't even have an website or whatsoever that most of the traders will lure you into after a 1.5 hour freaking video telling you that they will tell you a strategy while in fact it is just a freaking sales talk, and they not tell you everything, they only tell you what you already know. That's that you should pay for something like that. I'm not like that. For the moment, I don't have any plans of putting up a chat room, paid or whatsoever. I have a chat room, that's my freaking YouTube channel, and I hope you're going to use it properly. Yeah, don't place nasty comments on it or whatsoever. That's not cool. Yeah, we provide this for free at the moment, and it will stay for a long time for free. I think probably forever, because as long as we can make an income together, why would I charge you even more? You know, the internet is there for information to be free, not to be paid for. So let's help each other. Yeah, let's provide the information that can help each other. And hey, if you can grow your trading account and I can grow my trading account, then it's a win-win. Anyway, I don't have any more to add, honestly speaking. I did the analysis already. I told you why you should use a stop loss. I showed you my account. And again, also the reason I never used stop losses, or I placed stop losses that were way above the risk management ratio. You should never risk more than 1 or 2% of your account. And I'm just playing around a little bit, because the big boys on the internet always say that you never should risk 1 or 2% of your account. But let's be honest, ladies and gentlemen, 2% of a 100,000 buck account is a stop loss that is bigger than 2% of a 300 buck account. And they can actually handle the swings. And they don't care if they lose, I don't know, A lot. I'm not really a good mathematician, but if you have 100,000 buck account and you have a 2% stop loss, yeah, because your risk management says 2%, then we're talking about a 2,000 buck stop loss. A 2,000 buck stop loss, yeah, can I show you up here? Yeah. It is so freaking big. It doesn't even fit my chart. No, 2,000 bucks stop loss here. Of course you can handle trades. Yeah, this is 1,700 buck. You would never be stopped out with your trade. Never. Of course you can do something like that. What the hell? But for, even for a 10,000 buck account, yeah, it's 200 buck. 200 buck on a 10,000 buck account is a stop loss that goes around. Is this now again? You go away. It's around here, 200 buck. This is a 200 buck stop loss. The chance that it is being hit, I'm talking about a month. This is a month. A month chart, ladies and gentlemen. Even in the week. In the week chart, 200 buck is around this area up here. You can easily chicken out if you have a loss of 80 euro because you see clearly that the market will not go into your favor. Yeah. But with a 300 buck account, you have a stop loss of 6 euro. That's not really something that you want to do, right? I will be out already. That's why I'm saying, should you use or not use a stop loss? I'm still convinced that you probably should. On the other hand, the market might dip for 7, 8 bucks, 9 bucks. I saw that already in the past. It dipped for a freaking 7, 8 euro, stopped me out, and went to the direction that I bet it on. And that's not cool, ladies and gentlemen, to know that you're correct, but you stepped in way, way, way too early. Patience is what my next video will be about. Tomorrow I will do a nice live broadcast, and we will continue with the trade to see how this unfolds. I'm not going to chicken out or whatsoever. That is absolutely not what I wanted to do, but I will show you tomorrow in a nice new video what it is to place a small stop loss, being chickened out, being stopped out, and the market moves in the direction that you actually went for. You can see it in areas like this. You placed a nice trade, you did the stop loss, the market goes back, and then it shoots back up. You place your trade here, for example, with a stop loss of, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 bucks. This is already 10 euro, as far as I know, it's 1000 pip. 1000 pip is I think around 8 euro, this is as far as I know. 2600 pip, and that's a loss of 23 euro. So you can count it, you can do the math yourself. You will be stopped out by this nasty candle and otherwise by this nasty candle. Being stopped out because your stop loss is somewhere around here. Or you use a trailing stop, whatsoever. But I will show you my trades that I had with this. I had some nice trades actually going on here that are being stopped out because of that here, all my stop losses. Trades that didn't place a stop loss, those are on zero. And the trades that I had a stop loss are usually always being hit. My take profit is hit, is not really hit that much. Some of them are trailing stops, honestly speaking. And trailing stops are not really green. They also show as red. I still don't know why. Because the trailing stop is in the plus. You can see that you can see that here, for example. It's in the plus. You can see that here. It's in the plus. All the stop losses are in the plus. Those are all trailing stops. Being stopped out because of a retracement. And then it went up in the direction that I actually bet it for. It's really nasty to be in such a situation. This one also, it went up. It pushed me out with a 5.92 buck take profit. And eventually, it went to the direction. Because look at the price up here. 26,462. My take profit was 25,948. I could easily have it if the retracement was not as big as was not so big as my trailing stop points were. Trailing stop can be, oh, you can see that up here. You probably can see the For those who are already trading with MT4, you can you can put a trailing stop on your account or on your bets, and you can customize them on how many points you wanted to have. I recommend for this market to have a trailing stop of at least 2,000 points. 2,000, but yeah, it's going down 2,600 points already. So you would be stopped out again. And that's also how long do you want to trade? You want to do day trading? You want to do intraday trading? You want to do long term? That's a little bit up to you. I'm just seeking for a nice trade. And if I have to be in for a week, I will be in for a week. If I have to be in for a day with pushes like this, for example, I will also do that. This is just a few hours, 3 hours of nice big money. Believe me, you could actually earn on this nice if you just traded that one. You had a nice daily income. And that's what we do it for, right? We do it for a nice daily income. And how can you actually guess what this would do? Oh, that's the, I'm always boxing it in. It starts to consolidate a little bit, and yeah, when are you deciding that it consolidates? Well, that's really hard to decide, honestly speaking. But this is for me already a sign that it starts to consolidate, and then you just place your lines. Yeah. This was the first sign for going down. It consolidates here. It tested it again. Here it is being rejected. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rejections. You have to do it sometimes. Here you would probably already be in with your stop loss somewhere around here. So you would still be in for a short trade. And here it would be paying off. And if you stayed in, yeah, it consolidates again, so that doesn't really matter. You could have actually sold this one if you were present on the trade. And sorry, you just went out with a nice big profit. And this is the entry points on how you can detect it. It broke consolidation, so you probably go in for a short. But this is still too early to do that. You could also go in here for a short because it violated here. This candle violated all of this up here. So even for those who went in here, I can have a calculation tool somewhere around here. I have a calculation tool, right? Tools, no, hold on guys. As far as I know, there is a calculation tool here somewhere. No? No, there is no calculation tool here. Online there is a calculation tool with my provider that can calculate how many percentage this is. I wanted to show you how much that was, but I cannot find it up here. And let's not waste that much of a time anymore. It's not cool. What you can use, and I want to show that also for the moment, are moving average. There is a moving average that you can actually use. I have that on the chart up here. This one is too messy. Here, what the hell is this? There are too many lines in this one. Oosh. This is the NOS and the Euro. I will just place it in here. Insert indicators. We have trend, moving average. We do an exponential 50. And we do an indicators, moving average, trend, moving average, we take 20. Let's take a different color for that one. We have 20. And you can do an indicator, moving average, which is a 200. And let's take a different color for that one also. This was already a sign. You could see it already, the crossed. For a downtrend to occur, do know that you can use the moving averages for that, exponential or simple. That doesn't really matter that much. If you put this one on a simple and you put this one on a simple, yeah, you can actually see a much clearer signal. It broke here. Yeah, what was the first signal for it to go down? And no, this is not really lagging. This would be already visible by this candle. A lot more visible by this candle. So as I said, this would be your entry point for going down. I said it already earlier, not even based on the moving averages or whatsoever. And it is indeed, if you ask me, a signal for going down. Here it breaks also. And it is not really that simple. So the simple moving average is better. Anyway, if you're not in the trade up here, you could still go in the trade up here. It's all probability. Eh? I'm not going to say that this would guarantee you that it would go down, because now I'm basically doing what I said I wouldn't do, and that is basing my decisions on a chart that is already unfolded. We do not know what the market will do. I can show you numerous of examples that the market gave a signal going down, right here, with a signal of going down. It broke, right? The probability is that it would go down, not a guarantee. And as you could see, it went up, and it went up a lot. But it told you it would go down, right? Yeah, probability seen. Here is the same. You could have entered here and exit up here. And that is a nice trade, but you would probably be stopped out by this freaking candle up here with your stop loss. Yeah. So although it is a nice signal, and although it works most of the times, do know that there are more than enough occasions that this would stop you out. And that is why a good risk management system is just simply needed. It would protect your account, and also it will minimize your losses and maximize your profits. Still, I know I didn't do it myself, so it might be a hard lesson. And let's just see what this would do. Like I said, I'm not going to close the trade. As you could see, it's already going back up for €2, which can be with the 1.0 account, that would be $200. I would also be in a loss for $2,000, but that's another story. Anyway, this could be a signal for it to go down. And how do you determine your exit point? Yeah, exit points can be determined, I think, and I would devote another video on that. If you take your Fibonacci retracement and you take it from this point to this point, an exit point can be the 31.2, 38.2. You went in on the 1 hour chart, you went in somewhere around here, and you go out somewhere around there. Don't blindly take exactly 38.2, go always a little bit above it or below it. It can be a nice indication for where to enter and when to exit. You could see it here. It was a nice entry point. Also, this was a nice entry point. Anyway, we're not going to talk about the past. The past is being done, and the past will not repeat itself. And I am not going to use indicators, as like I said, I will usually trade naked as much as possible. Not really naked. That would be nasty. But naked on the chart, and I will base my trades as far as possible on weak resistance or body. In this case, I do week to week, so I should also do the week up here. I think I can also take this one. It has more hit points. That was it. So as far as I know, also a daily one. Yeah. It is here and here. It's a nice, for me, a nice point to draw the line up. And you can see it goes back up again. Let's just see how this will unfold, ladies and gentlemen. At the moment, I really don't know. It's still consolidating, if you ask me. And I will see you back. I hope to see you back tomorrow. And again, like it, comment it. Subscribe to my channel, and let's help each other grow, both on knowledge level and on trading level, money level, whatsoever. You can follow my trades if you like. You don't have to. I'm not your financial advisor or whatsoever. Please read the disclaimer. It's your own choice when to enter, when to exit. It's also your own choice if you follow me, yes or no. I've tried to minimize my risks as much as possible, but as you can see now also, I will be honest about it. I have really high risk profile. 21 euro with a 0.01 contract loss. That's just simply too much. But no pain, no gain, right? That's what they say also. But seriously, ladies and gentlemen, the risk management should be in order for you to become a profitable trader. And I have to work on that, and I hope that I will learn it, and I hope I will learn to be consistent and even become more consistent while making those videos, because I will repeat it every single time again. Be consistent and always choose if you should use a stop loss, yes or no. And if you're not using a stop loss, which is fine, you don't have to use a stop loss to begin with. Close the trade if you see that it goes in the min. Better take a loss around this point. Yeah, let's say 500 pip or whatsoever, or 1000 pip. You could do that. It's not an issue. But you shouldn't let it go down like this so much. And never, never add to a losing trade. I did it. I placed a trade here. You can actually see that. That was a trade from yesterday. The trade gave me eventually 36 cent, 39 cent. Yeah, this one. I entered on 26.105. I will remove you a little bit. I will remove you. I entered on 26.105.8. I entered up there. I placed a trailing stop of 900 points. It shooted up here. It activated my trailing stop. And it smashed me out on this candle. Here, 8.55 is a 1 hour candle. 1 hour candle. No. 8.55 here. This candle with the big wick pushed me out. Pushed me out. And that's a waste, because if I would be in a trade, if I would be still in the trade now, I would have at least gained around 5-6 buck with the second trade, and this trade is also already here 5-6 buck lesser than it was on this point. So it would be, it would double up, and it would be 12 euro, 12 buck. Yeah. Doesn't matter, I'm not going to enter the market again. You know why? I think this would go down more. I'm not really sure. I see some nice pushes up here on the 1 hour candle, and the 4 hour candle is being pushed also nicely up. So this might actually break and just go back up and continue its way to the moon. By the way, it will never go to the moon. It would physically leave Earth, and that's impossible. But honestly speaking, this is a nice 4 hour push. The candle still needs to, the 1 hour candle will finish in 50 minutes, so everything can happen. It can generate a week like this. You never know. But let's just see. I will be back here tomorrow with a new video and with some new information about the current trend, the current trade. And I hope to see you guys tomorrow. And please subscribe my channel. Please subscribe it. Please like it, comment it. Do I need to improve something or whatsoever? Please let me know so I can improve and make it better and nicer for you to listen to. And yeah, have a nice evening, have a nice day. I don't know what time zone you are, but enjoy it, and I hope to see you soon. Goodbye.